and good afternoon to you. My name is Grace Mishere, and I am the host of the TV program, The Roars for Christ International. And today I want us to talk about a topic. You know, many of us are at home. Many of us are, we are not in school anymore. And you know that in our program, we usually bring young students in their schools showing their talents. And that is what this YouTube channel also has been doing. But for now, we are all at home. And we want to see, we have the internet, some of us are studying online, some of us are using the TV, the radio to study. And we want to see, those of us who have the internet at home, how do we use this internet so that we don't get distracted, so that we make sure by the time we're getting to next year, when God willing, we are going to get back to school, that we're going to be better than the way we were, not worse than the way we were when we were coming out of school. So today we are talking about remaining mentally sober in the wake of negative and wrong social media influence. And this is a topic that I had spoken with a few students on a Zoom mentorship that is going on, courtesy of one of our members called John Jane, a teacher at Moi High School, Kabarak. And today we are talking about this because it is an important topic and we need to talk about it. You know, many of us don't know, and that is why we fall prey to some of these things. So today we are here to inform you so that you can be aware and you can operate from the position of power, which is the power in knowledge. Okay, first of all, we are going to divide this into two parts. The first part is this one, that we're going to have an introduction and to see the effects that social media has on us, the how it was designed and why it is so addictive. Why can't we live without it? And the second part, we are going to see, if I'm looking down, I'm looking at my book, how we are going to run away from social media addiction. So this first part, the first thing that I would like for you to understand is that social media is not evil. It was not created by the devil. The devil is not a creator, he's a perverter. He takes what has been created by God and turns it around to use it for his own uses. And so social media is good, it is helpful, it is noble, but how you use it is up to you. That is where the free will factor comes in. And so I just want to encourage even the parents who are watching us, social media is not evil, it is the choices that we make on that medium that is the problem or the good thing in that, for that matter. So with this in mind, we know that the internet is not evil. What we do with it is what counts. There have been recorded cases. We know so far there's a lot of depression and a lot of mental health issues during this time of COVID-19. And for me and many of the experts and psychologists out there, they know that the main problem is this social media use. You know, right now we are having very heavy social media and internet use, and that is not necessarily good for us. We know even in the stock market, some platforms like Netflix have really grown in their stocks, and their stocks are going higher and higher even if everything else is crashing. Why? People are watching more movies, people are watching more things on the internet, and that is why that is happening. And it has been seen in recent times by psychologists that social networks have been linked with disorders like low sleep quality, people are not able to sleep very well. Bullying, of course, we cannot even start talking about cyberbullying. And not just cyberbullying, even the physical bullying. Body image issues. When you are watching, looking at someone on the internet, every woman actually has someone that they think is more attractive than them. And so when you're looking at someone on the internet who has been photoshopped to look perfect, your brain doesn't know how to register that that might not be true. So for you, it makes you have a negative body image, and that is definitely not good for you. FOMO. FOMO is it's an abbreviation for fear of missing out. So people are on social media because they say, oh, I don't want to miss, I want to be the first one to know, among the first to know anytime anything changes. So that's another thing. Anxiety and depression. When you fear missing out and when you have negative body image, when you're not sleeping well enough, of course you're going to be anxious and you're going to be depressed. So this is all according to a study called Hashtag Status of Mind, a survey published by the UK Royal Society for Public Health. Now, the number one negative, let's call it negative, social media platform is Instagram. Followed by Instagram, followed by Snapchat, then Facebook, then Twitter, and the least harmful, according to this survey, is YouTube. Why? Because YouTube is said that it kind of promotes healthy content, it kind of promotes, like you have more power over what you see on YouTube than what you see on all these other platforms. But Instagram is the very worst. Young people who spend more than 2 hours online have higher cases of depression and anxiety than those who spend lower than 2 hours online every day. So are you spending more than 2 hours online every day? That's bad for you, because this promotes something called compare and despair attitude. So when you see someone else, especially on Instagram, doing better than you, you compare yourself. Like we said, the mind doesn't know how to register that. No, this cannot be real life. Maybe that person is their first time to go to the beach. You even live in Mombasa, but you feel like, hey, if that, this person has gone to this and this hotel, then they must be doing much well, much better than me. And your brain doesn't know how to distinguish. And so spending more than 2 hours online is not good for you. Most people post their happy times. They are called the highlight reel. However, your brain does not distinguish. It's bad for them too, because they do not live in the moment or enjoy. So for that person who is posting, it is bad for them. Why? They're not living in the moment. All they are doing is taking photos and editing and putting filters so that they can post online. For you who is watching, who is the audience, it's also not good for you, because you are looking and comparing and despairing and thinking your life is boring and doesn't have a mwelekeo, we say in Kiswahili, doesn't have a direction. But that is not the truth. You probably are doing much better than that person you're watching and envying online. Okay, so how can we make informed choices and decisions? This is the second part we are going to talk about. And then in the next segment, we're going to talk next week, we are going to talk about how we can run away from social media addiction. So right now, let's talk about how can we make informed choices and decisions online. We've said it's not a bad platform. All of them are good. But how can you make sure you're not a victim? First of all, there are a few things I would like for you to discover and understand, because when you understand, even when you go to the points, you're going to understand better why these points are so important. So the first thing is, first of all, realize that they trade in your time. And this is very important. In accounting, we talk about the time value of money. That $1, the value of $1 today, is not going to be the same value of the same dollar in the next year or in the next 5 years. The more the time goes, the more the value of that dollar changes. Now, there's also time value on the internet. Why? The more time you spend on a platform, the more money they make. So kama you are always on YouTube, if you spend 2 hours on YouTube every day, actually, the average person spends 2 hours on YouTube every single day and 58 minutes on Facebook every day. So that is almost 3 hours of your life wasted, and you only have 8 hours to work. Anyway, let's not get into that. So if you're spending that 2 hours on YouTube, they want to make sure to keep you there as long as possible. Why? Because when they keep more people there for longer, they can go to advertisers, to corporates, and tell them, we have 2 billion users of Facebook, and each of them uses 58 minutes a day. So you can advertise with us for this amount. So they make money out of your time. So if I were you, and this is something also I try to do as much as I can, is make sure that you're gaining something from your internet consumption. Don't just give them money. You're giving them your time, so you're giving them money. Make sure you're gaining something also, because business is two-way, okay? Make sure you're building your capacity. You can also see this in billionaires. You know, billionaires, they don't only use their vehicles. They have very good cars, many of them. But they also spend their time to buy choppers, hundreds of millions of shillings, and even more millions to fuel these choppers to go from place to place. Why would they use all of that money? Why can't they give it to the poor, you know, use it to invest somewhere? It is because that they understand that the time they use traveling from A to B is so important, and they know they don't have time to waste. So they'd rather spend so much money buying a chopper than spend time doing nothing, waiting to get to a place. And so if you want to adopt a billionaire mindset, know that time is money. Time is valuable. I'd like to talk about a few of the people who have made these social media platforms. One of them is Mark Zuckerberg. He's the founder of Facebook. And in one of his open letters to his young daughter, he has a small daughter, he was telling her that learn how to stop and smell the roses. So he was telling her, in other words, learn how to live in the moment. And in that letter, surprisingly, there was nothing to do with Facebook or the internet. He didn't tell her, you have to come and take up the company. He didn't tell her, I want one day for you to be the CEO. He only told her, remember to stop and smell the roses. That's the founder of Facebook for you. Second person is Steve Jobs. We know Steve Jobs is the co-founder of Apple Incorporated. And Steve Jobs, when the iPad came out, he confessed in 2011 that his children had not even used the newly released iPad, and he was not going to give it to them until they become older. He said, "We limit how much technology our kids use at home." That is the founder of Apple, your iPhone, your iPad over there. He's the one, and your iPod. He's the one who has a hand in all of that, and he doesn't let his children even use it as much as you use it. Bill Gates, we know, is the founder of Microsoft, one of the richest people on earth. We're talking about Bill Gates, and Bill Gates sets time limits on his screens for his home. He doesn't allow phones on the table at home, and his children got their first phones. They didn't have any phone until they were 14 years old. So these are people who have made these platforms, and they are the ones who limit their children. They protect their children because they understand the effect of these things on us. Even movie stars, we can check movie stars and see most of them don't even allow their children to watch the movies that they have starred in. Some of them have even made children's content, and their own children don't watch that children's content. Don't you think you should also protect yourself as much as they are protecting their children? Parents, don't you think you should know what your young person is watching and what they are listening to? I think you should. And so with all of this in mind, next week we are going to talk about how it is that we can make informed decisions on the internet, and also how we can run away from social media addictions. We are going to give you tips. We are going to give you the tricks. We are going to give you the insights that you need so that you can make informed decisions. Don't trash it, but use it effectively. God bless you. I'm going to see you next week for another episode right here on the Royce channel. Remember to subscribe and click the notification bell so that you can be informed every single time that we post a new video. We are here to help you. Until we go back to school and we meet you in school, we are going to meet right here on YouTube and on Facebook. God bless you. Remember to share with someone. Don't get this knowledge alone. Share with someone, and you might be a lifesaver for someone else. See you next week.